this. What a great pleasure it is to be wherever the fuck we are. This is just... I have never in my entire life felt like a motivational speaker transplanted to the funkiest bunker in 1940s Berlin. This... Just be the best you can be. That's how they got into the trouble. It's a great joy. It's a great joy, ladies and gentlemen, to be back once again in Brighton, the only place where people can make a wicker man ironically. And it's a... I don't know. I'm glad that some of you enjoyed that. You've probably bought a couple in the North Lanes. Now, it's a great joy. It's a great joy, folks, as I come out here. And if I sound like I'm talking too fast, don't worry. This is just what happens when ADD meets cocaine. We're going to have a wild time, you know. That's actually a real thing. A wild time in a private school education. And can I point out, when I made the faint reference to Hitler, I wasn't in fact referring to your haircut, which I find astonishingly alarming, and I'm going to fuck off. Just genuinely, there was just a moment when I looked down and just kind of went, about 70 years ago, you'd have been a hit in a part of the world you wouldn't have wanted to be. Excuse me a moment, it's great to be here. Now, hang on, no, I remember you. No. Now, the thing is, my darlings, it is a great pleasure. And also, just may I say while we're here, just check this out. Did you genetically engineer this guy? Now, that took too fucking long. That took too long. I was just offensively saying that he's blonde, and that's fine. And I just want to let you know, Ken, when Barbie there, obviously, you know, that's... I mean, that's obvious, Mummy Barbie, and that's okay, you know, that's okay. I'd throw myself a Mummy Barbie, don't worry about that, you know, have my prawn. Thing is, my darling, which I believe is a South African reference, what I would just like to point out... I hate you. Your handsome, smooth face, I hope you don't have a penis. You understand me? You know? I mean, it's not that I was beaten at school by people who looked like you, it's just I wish I had been, you know? I don't want to sound perverse in any way, but I would like to fuck you in the place where you don't have a cock. You know, that's all I'm saying, you know? I want to come to your man, Hyman, and just fucking pound it with my normal, generic genitals. You understand me? I'll do you in front of your mother. Don't worry about it. We're just going to have a wonderful time. Are you his father? You don't know. It's a great pleasure. When they assembled you at the Mattel factory, you know, how wonderful. They just put an arm everywhere, didn't they? You know, that's fine. I should probably talk to the others, but I am literally transfixed by this artificial man. I want to put a wick on top of him and fucking burn, you know? It's a great joy. You know, the rest of you are fine. I have no problems with the rest of you except for you. And no trouble. No trouble at all. And don't... I was bullied at school. That's why this is happening. But once again, not by people like, I will fuck you. Now, thing is, and also, may I just say down here, sir, you have a beard and you have nothing to fear from me. You have a mouth like a hairy clam. I will not come anywhere near you, sir. You look like the sort of thing that pirates used to lose legs in. You understand me? And I will also just point out, behold, ladies and gentlemen, it is a piece of body language. Body language entitled Insecurity to the Max. This woman is holding him down. And I don't mean in the course of your relationship. I don't know you well enough to make that statement. But can I just say, there's something quite wonderful about seeing someone who's done this. Hang on. This one's different from the others. He may have a problem. My husband, what's distinctive about him? Beard! No! One hand on the thigh. Just stay there. Just stay there. Whilst he puts one hand over that in a comforting manner, may I say, just to hide his erection. And that's fine. That's completely... I know. Every time... Whenever someone gets on stage, we're just blocking the view of this pariah over here, you know? It's an incredible... Look at him laugh. Look at him laugh. He doesn't have the full spectrum of human emotions. He's on the spectrum. That's why. Now... Thing is, my dears, you seem like lovely people. If you were on fire, I would throw you a stick. If you were drowning, I would piss on you. I suppose that's meant to be the other way around, but so was I when I came out of my mother, and now she walks funny and I get turned on by being strangled. Now... Get your foot off the stage. Get your foot off the stage. I'm Australian. That's my land. You fuck off. Now... You can apologise in 200 years, but with that face, I won't believe it. Now, the thing is, what I quite like... Can I just point out one thing I like about this suit is that when I wear this, men on the street don't hassle me. You know what I mean? Like, street gangs are afraid of me for reasons I don't understand. It's quite... You know, none of you understand either. I look like I can cause you harm in ways you've never factored into your lives, you know? It's a strange thing. I look like the sort of man who's going to kick you and sing selections from Cabaret. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. I'm aware that for some of you that was too many teeth, and that's okay. And may I also just say hello, hello young ladies, I can't go back to jail, I'll be here. Now, merely because I leant down and I just kind of like, I'm nightmare fuel, excuse I momentarily, I'll come here to a much more neutral, no, it's not neutral at all, except for that. Now, the thing is, my darlings, I wish to get to know everyone. Now, I've known people in my life. I've got a vegan friend who's into bondage. It's great. I mean, she's sexually attracted to leather and morally opposed to its production. So she walks around practicing what she calls free-range bondage, where she doesn't tie herself up, she just feels guilty. And she calls... It's nice that they untied those people so they could clap, you know. I will just... You know, she calls it free-range bondage. You probably know it by its formal name, Catholicism. And, you know, that's fine. Yeah, Brighton's the right town to have done that one in. I've done it in Glasgow. I've been knifed, okay? I've been knifed with a grin and a cheeky chat. Billy Connolly ran away afterwards. I got his autograph etched into me. Now, thing is, I wish to get to know everyone, and it doesn't matter if you have been assembled from parts of better men. I just... Look, I know it's gone too far, and look, eventually I'll bring it back, and I will put my mouth on you. All right? I don't even like boys, and that's why I've picked on you, okay? You know, it's a wonderful thing. I like the fact your mother's laughing. This is a wonderful thing. And at this point, I'd have stepped in to defend him, but don't worry. I've obviously never had a child, and neither of you. You build him out of a kit. However... I'm actually quite lovely, but it's been a really long day. Now, it's been 24 hours like normal. Now, the thing is, my darlings, I wish to get to know everyone who is here in this possibly the most secure area here in Brighton, should the bombs ever fall again. I wish to get to know everyone. So if any of you were born... ever, you just make a noise for me now. That is good and that is reassuring. If any of you were born in the 1940s, let me know. Now, to be fair, I've walked down this crowd. I've seen you. Just turn it on and you can respond. It's all right. It's not ageist if they don't know. Now, the thing is, if any of you were born... That took a while. If any of you were born in the 1950s, let me know. Hold on. I have never... That was the best group depiction of manic depression I've ever seen in my life. Woo! Oh. It's morning. Woo! Oh, again. Oh. Now, may I say, 1950s people, you are brave, and I commend you for coming out. Because you guys, I mean, you don't... Obviously, this is a huge alienating thing for you. You don't still go out, because you guys are spun out by the fact that MASH ended. And, you know, that's okay. It's all right. If any of you were born in the 60s, let me know. Now, listen. What a difference marijuana makes to a generation. You people have no idea where you are, but my God, you're happy. That's why they put these tiny lights in. You don't know comedy's on. You're just sitting there waiting for Pink Floyd. Now... If any of you were born in the 70s, let me know! Yeah! That's a very nice roar. That's the difference cocaine makes. Now, I was born in the 1980s. Any of you born in the 80s, let me know! Yeah! Now, you hear that sound? Other generations? You hear that? That proves something. My generation still has energy. Because we are the first generation to accomplish nothing. Now, my darlings, they've given me the red light, which means that my time has ended here, and... That's lovely of you, but it really just will be more abuse. You are a lovely group of people. I will... How old are you? 18. Old enough. No cock. My name is John Robertson. Thank you so much.